Okay guys, I'm back. I cut some pieces for the cover over here. Let's see. For this one. So I cut at 4 inches by 6 inches for this one. It's gonna be over here, and I'm going to, I forgot, we're gonna use some strip inside here to cover when you open it. You know what, I need another piece inside for the flap inside, you know what I mean. So this one gonna be 6.5 by, how deep is it? I forgot about this one, guys. Seriously. I don't know. Maybe 3 inches. Let's see. Maybe I can use this one. So this is gonna be 3 inches, right? So I'm gonna cut this side at deep 3 inches, and gonna be 6.5. Maybe a little bit shorter than 6.5 because inside, not outside envelope. Let's see. If I cut 6 inches first, 6.5. Sorry. Yeah, this one's 6.5 by, guys. So this one gonna be the flap one. So this from here to here gonna be what is it? We have to just 1 5/8. We have to score like 1 5/8. Gonna fold the line, so we cut this one with the flat inside. We set this one inside. See right here. Have to fold this one in, clip together. You know what? So take this one out. See, you have to make sure this one is go pretty well. I can actually trim a little bit hair off, okay. So let's see. Oh, put the wrong upside down. I wonder why it's not matched. It upside down. Okay, so that better. So this one gonna be inside. See that? So now I can you know, I'm not gonna bother the hole, so I'm going to gonna use fake button outside anyway. Now here the expensive part is scor-tape. I'm gonna use scor-tape because if I use some other auto adhesive, it might take longer, but this one is kind of oily adhesive. You just use the water, so I'm going to use I'm gonna spray this one later, I suppose. But I'm going to use some adhesive on that side there. gonna have really important part is you don't want it to get bubble, have to use adhesive on there. So you guys, maybe you guys be better if you use a 6x9, but this one I use a lot of paper because it's 6.5x9.5. So when I cut the flap, it's used 6.5, and the one left, oh, you can use on that. So you guys want to make use 6 inches by 9. So on this one, I'm going to peel this one off first. I'm sitting right here because Cody wants his maybe Mickey Mouse channel on his daddy computer, so I don't have to be around him. He usually just ignore mommy and daddy. I'm trying to go this one in the corner first because I pressed it down. Not even, but it's better. So this one I'm going to trim the excess off there. And now for the flap outside, because you're not going to see another side, you know, another side I'm going to cover with the whole paper like this. So this from here to here, it just popped in my head first. I just cut all the pieces, you know, but now I'm going to cover all this with the paper. So this one about 11 inches by 1/8. So, well, before we adhere this piece, we have to binding together. You know what I mean? That means have to do the last part. And now we're gonna worry about this one later. Now I'm going to adhere this paper in the front. So this one going to be 6 inches by 4 inches. You know, you can, I don't know, you can cover all this you want on side here. Well, if you use 6 inches by 6 inches, it's, you don't have to, you know, use it perfect. But this one saying I use the envelope 9.5 by 6.5, so my envelope gonna look like this. But I'm going to on edges here, I'm going to paint this in black acrylic paint. Oh, let's try this dress thing, okay. I'm going to try to use this, I don't know where all my sponge makeup go. Going to use one test photo here. Let's see how it's, oh, I'm going to use this one, the one with clean one. See how the color would look like. If I don't like it, I can, you know, paint it. Let's see. I deserve this. Let's see, this is how it looks like. What do you guys think? Or should I paint the whole thing in black acrylic paint? I don't know. I will paint the paper before. Maybe I might try. Really sure where all my acrylic paint in black. So saying I don't have black, so should I use brown one instead? I have metallic black one. Okay, so you gonna try metallic one here. Let's see what it looks like. Well, because I disturbed the edges, it's giving me that look. I'm not sure that I like it or not, but hey, I try. So paint on the what is called the back of this. Yeah. Not on this side because we're gonna cover with the paper. What are you doing? Sorry if I'm off the camera, guys. Try not to get messy on my paper. I don't think I'll be able to finish the project tonight, and tomorrow I have to go to work early in the morning, guys. So let that one dry, and we're gonna try first with how it look like. So I'm gonna stop paint this one. I think I'm going to heat to dry that one and try to adhere the paper. get the because metallic get the shimmer look a little bit. So I love this couple here, so this one going to be just like that, guys. See that? Love it. See that one. Okay, now I'm going to use some scrap paper to cut to make like template. You know what I'm talking about, guys? I'm going to use this one inside to cut that curve to get to trade. So this one gonna be cereal box here, 6½, and I'm going to insert this one. Well, this one is not going there. So this one have to be a little bit. More. Yep. So I'm going to put that one in there and I'm going to use my pen here to trade. See, this is my template. Go. So this is my template here. It's going to be a little bit hard because yes. So I'm gonna trim this one because then this is 6 inches. So that one can light up properly. Now turn over. Going to trade and trim it off. Where my pen? And then cut. Follow the line there. Right there. See? Now I can use this on the top of the envelope there. See that? So this one I'm going to use for this one. You can distort the edges if you want to. So I'm going to use the vintage photo. It doesn't matter, and you can really see the detail, right? So I'm going to adhere this one there. I'm going to use my scor-tape. I can hear my husband and Cody. Cody want a bathtub. Thank you. my finger, peel this one off. Oh, I don't know how many videos this is going to be, guys. Sorry guys if that's too long. You guys always can speed it up if you want. You don't want to watch too slow or hear me talking too much. Okay. To light this one up. It's hard for me to tell guys. I just worry it's not gonna get even. There guys, and now for the next one can be the one that I fold. This one I'm gonna put right here to the bottom. Okay, see it. But first we need the flap, another flap. I'm not really sure that should we make another pocket of this, so we just use the flap. So this flap is like a 2 inches by 6.5. So we can score at 1 5/8. Yes, I can finish only 2 videos for you guys tonight. Well, maybe 3, I don't know yet. But this one gonna be a flap there. See. So I'm going to use my scor tape. I don't know where my 1/4 inch scor tape, I keep losing it guys. So for on this one, I think I'm gonna leave it open so it can have more pocket. What do you guys think? So I'm going to light up this one, the flap, this flap, okay. So hard sometimes, I just worry it's not gonna get even. forgot about the corner that I have to trim it off. Never mind. I should know that I should cut, but forgot about that. Okay, I can learn from my mistake, right? I didn't use the glue between this one, huh? I'm gonna use some glue here, some wet glue. If it's overlap a little bit, I should trim it off. I have to stop video now. I will be right back on the next part.